Hey runners, I was setting up my Pace Pro from Polar and just want to continue this doing and making the video because, yeah, why not show it to you how simple it is to just set it up. So let's go in so you can see everything very clearly. But before we do that, perhaps a little bit of a close-up because it's very beautiful. And in the sunlight you can see it even better. You can see also like those nice scratches. It's not, I think, the correct word, but it looks like scratches on the side. I like that very much. He's very lightweight, so that's the thing I like the most until now. And by the way, if you liked the video, please hit the thumbs up. Then we're gonna set it up inside. I also have other Polars like this Ignite 2 and this Vantage M2. And what you can see already on the back side is the different modern system of the heart rate tracking on the back, because this is all flat and these were like little knobs which were pressing into your arm, but also this round circle is already a little bit pushing into your arm. So also this big round circle and also those four dots. That's also the case on the Vantage, and that's different with this Pacer Pro. And also the hump on the back side is a little smaller, or a little, I think it's way thinner. It's a little bit, it's still a little bit pushing up the back side. But that's also the case with the Garmin. The Garmin is even has also a bigger hump than this Pacer Pro. Also new Garmin. This is 245, but I also have like the Mark and the 945 and the Epix, and that has the same system. So on the Polar it's newer. So if we are here, we just look at the back side. So the Pacer Pro unit, this is the blue unit. When you buy it, you get in the box, of course, the charger, which I already took out of the small sack which came with it. And then you just push this magnetic thing on here. So, and what's nice about the Polar chargers, perhaps a stupid thing, but I like it, it's when you hang it like on the wall, on the socket, it just, it doesn't fall off, which is the case with some other watches. I think with this Kipron, that's the case. But it's also a compliment to the Polar, because most Polars are really light, and this is especially very light. So you see the size of this strap. What they also give you is an other strap, and this is the size S, so you can just tweak it how you like it. But that, what you want to do is just set it up so it's like not with the touch, but just with the buttons. So there are three buttons on the right and two on the left. So let's just give in the time. You can do it on the phone, on the computer, on the desktop computer, or on the watch. This time I will do it on the watch, so you can see how difficult or easy it is. So let's continue. This is always strange at Polar, and I don't like it, because this is a totally new watch. It wasn't launched in 2020, it was launched in 2022. Perhaps they started developing the Pacer in 2021, so I would think perhaps this year, but I don't know. Why would it be like, yeah, so strange? But minor thing, but why not make it a little bit easier? So there we go. Birthday. So if you want to congratulate me, do it on this date. Length. So you can't do like the tens and the this one and this one. You do just have to push it up and down. And then you know the weight is coming. Of course, here you can do it, so that's really nice. So 75 kilograms. You can of course, and that's not on this video. You can set it to kilograms or the other thing, the pounds. Yeah, I think so. Regular, frequent. I'm a frequent runner, heavy. Yeah, 5 to 8 hours a week. I think that's the case. It's in hours, so. Left hand, yeah. It's good that they make that default left hand. You like sleep and following your sleep habits. Yeah, 8 hours, yeah, that's a good thing to want, but it's not the really case. Moderate, heavy. Yeah, you can of course tweak it to your own desire. Connect to Polar Flow if you want to go. So here we are. So let's just push some buttons and see what happens. That's the case what most people do, of course. Most people don't want to read the book like me. I don't want to read any book, so they always stay in the box. Yeah, afterwards I will read the book because I wanted to show you, of course, everything. What is the case with this button? This is the light, can you see that? I think so, yeah. I think it's good visible, hopefully also on YouTube. And if you are looking on YouTube, please hit the thumbs up button. Thank you. So we go to the training page and then we go back. And we'll do that later on. So this is just activity level. So far, yeah. This is notifications and just, yeah, different sites on the home page going up and down. So now we push this button and we go to the training page. But what do we have here? The other things is the same with the Ignite and the Vantage and also with the GridX. So Serene is like the breathing thing. I think you know it. It's very good to do. I think most people will benefit from good breathing exercises. It sounds a little bit hokey perhaps for some people, but I think lots of sporters will have benefit when they do that correctly. The Strava live segments, of course. Strava, I love the app Strava. If you are on Strava, please follow me. It's just on this. If you look at on this on Strava, you find me. So I like Strava very much. The fueling, the timers, the tests. Perhaps you want to see the test, walking, running, fitness test. Because it's not only for runners, of course, but I think most runners will use this. So the settings. Yeah, just what I put in. So it works very easy. Also, if you never had a Polar before, I think it will take perhaps like 1 hour to just make it your own. And that's good of Polar. But it's also the case with Garmin, I must say. But not the case, for example, with this Kipron. It's kind of hard to do. So what we want to do is, of course, start a run. This is like telling GPS, making a lock. And we are now on the inside. So what sport activities do we have? On previous Polars, not on those two, but Polars before those, I think there was like a little bit of a moving picture here. So it's not the case anymore, but it should, I think it's also because of the battery life, because how brighter the screen is, how more like funny things are on a watch, how more it drains the battery. And you want to do like a marathon with a watch like this, or just like I like to go skating on ice for like, perhaps you know it, Elfstedentocht, it's Dutch. Nah, that's like 10 hours on the ice or something. And battery life is also a big thing, of course, on this unit, the Pacer Pro. And I have also like the Garmin Epix, but also other watches have like the really bright AMOLED screen, like the Apple Watch, also the Samsung watches, but it drains the battery really, really fast. So I wouldn't recommend it. Also, because does it have the touchscreen? It's also, I think, better for battery life. Some people like it, and yeah, I'm kind of in doubt. Sometimes I like it. I like it the most when not like sporting. So if you have the watch on your wrist And like when you are being cold, you just want to tap it and just go speak. Then it's easy, but